Well, Melbourne doctors on the virus front line say they feel sidelined in the battle against COVID-19, with poor communication contributing to potentially fatal delays in containing the spread.
GP and former Victorian AMA President Dr. Mukesh Haikerwal joins us now from Melbourne. Doctor, thank you for your time. You say you feel completely ignored in the battle against the virus. Can I ask why?
Unfortunately, it's historical. State authorities don't believe that general practice is part of the healthcare system in the state, and that's not Victoria alone. I think it's very important. There is about 500,000 consultations every week in general practice across the country. GPs work in their communities, they know the people that come to visit them, and they do their ongoing care. So it's really important that they're part of the system and part of the scheme, and currently they still are not being brought into the tent.
Okay, so I mean, obviously, your front page of The Age today in Victoria, your concerns are being voiced right around the country. Where is it going wrong? Why aren't you being consulted?
What we need to understand is that this is a national emergency. It may be in Victoria now, but unfortunately it'll go across the rest of the country, and the rest of the country can learn from what's happening here in Victoria. We need to make sure that everybody who's working in the healthcare system is properly engaged and is properly informed about when someone's having a test, what that result was, how that result is followed up if it's positive, what the quarantine rules are, what the isolation needs are until someone's got a result proven to be negative.
So there's basically no communication or clear communication between GPs on the front line and the health department at the moment?
There's no communication there. And the problem, of course, is people are having their tests done outside of general practice. So you don't know where the test is done, when it's done, how long the result's going to take, and if it's positive, what the guidance is for the tracing of the other members in the family, other people who are needing to be tested, to make sure that we remove people into isolation who are actually sick and therefore liable to spread it. We work in communities every day. We understand the needs of the communities. There are people with special language skills, the people who work with community leaders, that work with youth groups, and they're the ones that actually give a steer that the patients of Australia value. So the GPs see 500,000 people across the land every week.
In order to fix a problem, you have to know what the problem is, and you have to know where to lay blame in order to try and get it fixed. Where is the problem, and where do you think the blame should be laid?
Yeah. We've been working assiduously with state and federal authorities. They are aware of this, and things have actually changed and have got better. We are now starting to get some coordination, but simply not enough. This has to come from the top. There needs to be one voice, one group of people driving this agenda, and we, the GPs, are part of the jigsaw. Everyone has a part to play. The patients that come to the practice, they're fantastic. They're coming, they're wearing masks now, and we're seeing people doing the right thing there. People are staying at home, they need to keep doing that. We need to prepare our facilities to make sure that people who come in are safe. We keep them clean and we keep them the distance, and we wear masks and stuff like this to make sure people are kept in a safe way. The governments have their roles to play to make sure that they coordinate the effort. Use the people there that understand what needs to be done and work with them. You know, doctors work in this area every day, whether it's in aged care, whether it's in general practice, whether it's in hospitals. We're the ones actually bearing the brunt of this. Our risk every day is massive.
I mean, I think we can hear it in your voice how much you care about this and where you think the system is lacking at the moment. Come Wednesday, that will be 3 weeks of lockdown. Is it working?
Ali, I wish I could say it was. We've seen the worst numbers ever yesterday, 429. We had 10 deaths already in one night. In my own practice here, we had nobody coming through testing positive until July. Now we've got about 20. So really, it suddenly hits home that every person that has come through this tested positive, we have to be very wary about how we handle them and people around. We've got, you know, my staff here, they're all properly gowned up. You can see they've got these gowns, gloves, masks, visors, and we keep them safe. But, you know, ultimately, the only way to keep people safe is not to go out when you're particularly unwell. Remember, 20% of people don't have any symptoms. If you do have symptoms, the 80%, please get tested. please make sure that those guidances that you're given about staying at home after you've been tested are stuck to, and make sure that you follow the advice that's been given. And that includes wearing masks, and it includes washing, it includes keeping a distance, and includes making sure that the facilities that you work in, where you live, you keep clean down all the time, because this stuff is really important to make sure that you've got the right support and the right environment to stop the virus from replicating.
Well, there's a GP right there on the front line crying out for help and crying out for consistency, and surely on behalf of our authorities, we need to get that, make that happen. We keep saying it and saying it and saying it, and GP, a very leading GP, is on our show saying not enough's being done.